Hi, in this part, I will create an Node.js REST API and connect with our registration form. Before watching this, I recommend you to watch the first part, link in the description. To create the REST API and database connection, I need to install MySQL 2, Joy and BigCrypt. Now add database details in our default config file. First, database host, then database username, password and database name. This is our local database details, you can change according to yours. Next, add solve factor as 12. I will use this to encrypt the password, show you later on. Let's create a few directories. Here I follow MVC framework. First create services, then controls, schemas, utils and route. Inside utils, create db.utils to connect with database. Similarly, create user controls, user service, user schema files. Inside the dbutils, import config and MySQL 2 promise. Here I use MySQL 2 package to access MySQL methods with async and await. Now create a MySQL connection by using create connection method with connection limit, host, username, password and database. Then export the connection instance. Inside user service, let's create create user function. Firstly, I need to import config, bigcrypt and database connection instance. To generate encryption salt, I'm using gensalt method of bigcrypt and pass the salt factor. Then encrypt the password with the salt using hashSync method. Next, create an array with user data. Here I connect the database with await. Then create an insert query with binding params to protect from a SQL injection. Finally, execute the query with user data array. Using phpMyAdmin, let's create our user table inside our database. ID will be the primary key. Then full name, email, password, and join date. Join date will be the current timestamp. Let's create another function to check if email address exists in our database or not. Here I use a select query with count and store the count value inside row count. Then execute the query and check if it is returned 0 or not. Finally, export both functions. Inside user controller, I need create user controller function with 3 express parameters. Now fetch user given data inside user data object. Then check if user exists or not using check email service. If the user not exist, then pass the user data to create user service and response with 202 HTTP status. Else return with 410 HTTP status code. Finally, export this controller function. Inside user route, create a post request with our controller function. To validate the user data in the server side, I'm using user data schema. Inside user schema, I'm creating joy object with body data object. Here I also check if the confirm password match with user password or not. For schema validation, I need a middleware to validate resources. Here I passed options to not abort early and allow unknown. Then validate the schema with body, query, and params. I'm using modular function in our post request and pass the user schema. In the app root, add this user route inside app listener with await. Let's run this application. It's run without any error. Next, I need to connect this API with our previously created registration form. Here I'm creating a submit form function where I will prevent the default action. Then access the input fields with their name. Store the input fields data inside form object. Using fetch method, I will call the API and pass the value with JSON stringify. Then get the response data and show it inside PageMessageDiv. Call this function using onSubmit event of the form. Now decorate the page message in CSS. Let's check our form. It stored the data in our database properly. Here is the encrypted password. Our form does not clear after the submission. To clear our form, I need another function to clear each field. Here I remove all the classes. And values as empty. This function will trigger when we receive the value from the API. For more security, we can validate the form before submitting. Here I'm using the existing validation function. There is one problem, it fetches data from the event, not from the field. So I need another parameter to check if it is field or not. I put the default value as false. Based on the field type, our function will fetch data from the event trigger or directly from the field. Repeat the same thing in our password validation function. In the submit form, call the validation function by passing the true as field type. Let's check it. It shows email address already exists, as we already have the email address in our database. Let's try with different email. Here we go. Thanks for watching. Download the project from webgraphics.com. Link in the description. Please share your opinion in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe.